Well, hello there, everybody, and welcome back to the Miami Dolphins franchise. It's time for a brand new season, and I think it's safe to say that this is the game the Dolphins have been looking forward to since the schedule was announced during the offseason. You've got a chance to start your season at home after going 1-7 in this building last year and take down the team that swept you, and it happens to be a division opponent. Obviously, expectations are high for this Dolphins team with the draft they just had in 0-2 against the Bills, but 2-0 last season against Teddy Bridgewater, who comes over from New York, and we'll see him momentarily as Jason Sanders' kick to begin the season is going through the back of the end zone. No return for Zay Jones, and out comes the Buffalo Bills offense. Not a bad year last year for Josh Allen, but apparently not good enough for this Bills front office. They bring in Teddy Bridgewater, who's had some good games against us, but obviously has never won. And obviously getting his new tenure started against his new Dolphins front seven as he throws on first and 10 and complete to Corey Coleman over the middle for a first down. Obviously not what we wanted to see the first play of the season, gain of 10 yards. Up to the 35, a give here to Spencer Ware, left side, sheds off a tackle from Taylor, but taken down, there's Charles Harris. He and Robert Quinn have some big shoes to fill with Cameron Wake retiring. Here's second down to give to LaShawn McCoy, who's wrapped up in the backfield. Good stop there by Quinn. And here's a situation we would like to see this defense improve on from last year. Third and longs. Bridgewater has time. Looks outside. Finds a man as Zay Jones. First down. That'll get them barely across midfield as the rush did not get there in time. First down from the 49, Bridgewater hands off right side, McCoy with a little bit of space, a spin move to get him the first, and he might go the distance, and he will! McCain can't get there, it's a touchdown for LaShawn McCoy, and not the best first impression for this new-look Dolphins defense. That wasn't pretty. McCoy gave this defense a few issues last year, but you were hoping that Shazier, Suggs, Shane Ray, and Eddie Goldman would be enough to take him out of the picture, but so far that has not been the case. Obviously still some things we need to figure out with the scheme. Return unit on the field, and here's the rookie out of Missouri, Devin Alexander, on the return across the 30, and Alexander taken down just across the 35, and we'll see the Dolphins offense for the first time this year, and they're led by rookie quarterback Drew Madavi. Madavi, one of the many quarterbacks taken in the early goings of this past draft, and like many of those other quarterbacks, Madavi will be getting a chance to start here. Had a strong preseason, obviously a winner, led the Spartans to a Rose Bowl victory last year. And it's time to see what he can do. Madavi, first and 10, first snap of the year, is going to be a throw right side to Mike Gesicki. And a first down, there's a combination we should be hearing a lot this season. Madavi to Gesicki, there's 11 easy yards. Now going to the I formation, Madavi again looks to throw, pressure coming off the left, he takes off the run, look at the speed from Madavi getting across midfield, and a 6-yard run, he's got some wheels, better watch out. Now the Dolphins going to the pistol, second down give, here's Kenyon Drake, left side, got a nice block there from Sitton, and a first down for the Dolphins, already quickly approaching field goal range. This offensive line off to a pretty nice start. 39-yard line, Madavi hands off, here's Drake once again, lowers the shoulder, fights ahead, doesn't quite get the first, but close enough, here's second down. From the gun again, Kenyon Drake, and too easy, 5-yard run. It's a 3-for-21 start, and this offense already in field goal range. Play fake on first down, blitz picked up, Madavi could run, instead throws to the end zone for Kenny Stills, and pass broken up by White, that could have been trouble. Quick break in the action, we'll take a look at this new look Dolphins offensive line that started this year pretty strong for the most part. And of course our skilled players still roughly the same. From the gun on second down, Madavi facing a 4-man rush, going back to that same corner of the end zone, this time it's a catch! Vontae Davis whiffed, and Madavi to Alexander to start the season. And if this is the way we're going to start out the year scoring, I'm not upset at all. Madavi with one of the best throws we've seen out of any quarterback the past couple of years. And Alexander with the great route to get outside and the concentration to haul that in and get both feet down. This offense looks good. They ran well, obviously passed the ball extremely well. And for number 9, Drew Madavi, a great start to his career. We'll see what the defense can do on their next drive to hopefully turn things around as Bridgewater starts to the air on first down. His throw outside. There's Corey Coleman again as he beats McCain outside for another first down grab. That'll get them up to their own 40-yard line. Bridgewater hands off on first and 10, and there's Shane Ray coming unblocked off the edge. That's going to happen sometimes in this 3-4 look, and hopefully it continues to be a factor. Second down, Bridgewater. Play fake, steps up, trying to run, takes off, and somehow escapes for a positive gain. Has to be tracked down from behind and picks up 8 yards, setting up third and 3. Empty set for Bridgewater. Over the middle, this pass nearly intercepted. Ryan Shazier, good coverage. And here's the punt unit for the Bills as Alexander's deep to return once again. Inside the 10, he lets it bounce, and it stops inside the 5, recovered at the 2. And this is not where the Dolphins want to be. Kenyon Drake in the backfield. They give it to him on 1st and 10, and not much room to run. He's taken down by Trent Murphy for no gain. And a little trouble here. 3rd down, still at the 2. Madavi hands off once again. Drake trying to buy some space and able to get this one up to around the 3, but not much going that drive at all. Unfortunately, Miami forced a punt here. Matt Hawk on to send this one away, and this one's a great one. Goddard, the rookie corner, deep to return. He lets it go or maybe misjudged the football, and that could prove to be costly. The ball stops just before the 5, and that could be big-time trouble for this Bills offense. 1st and 10 from their own 6 as Bridgewater throwing over the middle, a completion to Clay, but hit hard by Jones. And we'll take a quick look at this revamped Dolphins defense. You want to know where all the money went this offseason? Pretty much this front 7. Eddie Goldman, the new starting defensive tackle. Terrell Suggs, Shazier, and Shane Ray make up the linebackers along with Raekwon McMillan. And of course, returning to Miami is Jamar Taylor. 2nd down for the Bills. Bridgewater throwing from his own end zone and on target for Clay again. This time good enough for a first. McMillan still a long way to go with his coverage skills. Here go the Bills to the ground game. And LeSean McCoy wrapped up by 3rd round pick. One of the 2 third-round picks is Christian Pedrino out of Eastern Washington. Miami had a pretty deep draft, and a lot of those players are getting starting snaps. Here's 3rd down. Bridgewater steps up. Check down McCoy. Close to the marker for the conversion, but not close enough. Minka Fitzpatrick, big-time tackle there, forcing 4th down. Back to Madavi. The football goes, and looking for a better drive this time around with better field position. And a nice start to the air for Kalen Ballage. That run good for 5 yards. 1st quarter of week 1 in the books. Here's quarter 2, and the Bills start with a blitz, and Madavi starts with a horrible throw intended for Devontae Parker. That was really close to being picked off there. Big time 3rd down upcoming. Madavi throwing, blitz incoming, protection holds up for the time. Bang, and Madavi's on target this time. 1st down grab again for Mike Gesicki, and Madavi starts 3 for 5, and this was another great throw with some touch. Just out of the reach of Craig Robertson, and Mike Gesicki just proves to be a mismatch for a lot of these linebackers in the NFL. Can't wait to see what he does this year. 1st and 10, Madavi again throwing underneath. There's Kenny Stills trying to get past White, and the move doesn't really get him anywhere, but that's still his first catch for 8 yards. Got to start somewhere. 2nd down, punt from Madavi, delayed. Give the Kenny and Drake, and fighting for every yard he can get. There's another 1st down. This offense looks good to get this year going. Here's Madavi outside. Devontae Parker, another great throw from Madavi. And the Bills having a hard time keeping these receivers covered. There's so much talent, and they can do so many things as Parker moves to the slot on 1st down. Madavi takes off the run. He's got space, and he's got the speed to get an easy 1st down inside the 20. First time in the red zone this year for the Dolphins offense. Madavi underneath. There's Devontae Parker again trying to make a move and able to get this one down to the 10. They're really working underneath this coverage. 2nd and short, shotgun play fake, screen left side. Kenny Stills has space, he's got the blocks, and Stills gets taken down at the 1 by Micah Hyde. So close to the end zone, but not quite close enough. 1st and goal from the 1. Can the Dolphins punch this in? Option keeper Madavi not gonna get there, shut down in the backfield, a loss of a couple. 2nd and goal now from the 3. A little more traditional look here. Kenyon Drake right side trying to find space. Sheds a tackle, but what is Durham Smythe doing? Did he even block anyone? They lose another yard. 3rd and goal now from the 4. Madavi, 3 tight ends to the air. Quick throw, and this one nearly intercepted. Luckily batted away. Pressure got there a little too quickly. And here's Jason Sanders. 1st field goal try this year is right down the middle. And it's 10-7 Miami. Obviously, you want a touchdown there, but Couldn't get it done that time around as the Bills offense back out there on the field and Clay keeping busy, another short gain. Third and three, a play later for the Bills. Bridgewater hands off here. Shady McCoy right down the middle and almost in the clear inside the red zone and finally tracked down by Taylor at the 11. What is going on with this front seven? You figured all the money the Dolphins spent this offseason, they would be great at stopping the run, but that has not been the case. Here's a give to Spencer Ware, first and 10 left side, and Ware picks up around three. Good tackle there by Shane Ray. Gotta hope they get a stop here on third down. 5 yards to go. Bridgewater, he's got all day. The rush can't get there. Bridgewater dancing, running, and finding the end zone for a Bills touchdown. They jump right back in front. Maybe it's just the rust. Maybe it's because this group hasn't played together for a long time, but this defense is really not doing their job right now. Still time, though, for the Dolphins offense to get back down the field. Here's Madabi with a clean pocket and throwing to Zach Miller. That throw is off the mark. Bad miss there once again for Madabi. And a third down upcoming. Toss left side. Kenyon Drake trying to get a first down, and Durham Smythe again just refusing to block anybody. Three and out Miami. Back to the Bills. The football goes, and here goes Bridgewater throwing downfield, trying to find Corey Coleman to get this drive going, and that's nearly picked off by Bobby McCain. Third and 10 upcoming, a play later. 18-yard line. LaShawn McCoy is wrapped up, thankfully. Looks like he had a chance to take that one a distance, but quick timeout called, and still time for the Dolphins to do something. Nortman sends it away, and Alexander deep to return, retreating inside his own 10, and he's going to bring this one out. Across the 15, Alexander with the spin. Got away from the second, but not quite from the third. But a great return from Alexander, brought down by Vontae Davis. And they'll get going from their own 28. Two timeouts to work with and plenty of time for the Dolphins. No need to rush, but Madavi going deep down the field and on target again. This matchup might be a problem. Madavi finds Alexander deep down the field again. Perfect touch on the football, and Tre'Davious White just not giving the rookie enough respect. Great off the line, has great down the field speed. Two grabs now for 67 yards plus the return yardage, and Devin Alexander well over 100 all-purpose. From the 32, play fake. Madavi, pressure coming off the right side, and Trent Murphy, first sack of the season for him, beating the rookie DeMarcus Casey off the right side. That'll back them up 9 yards. Surprisingly not burning one of their two remaining timeouts. Here's pressure once again, but off in time, Devontae Parker into the end zone and not even touched for a touchdown. And the Dolphins jumping back in front with little time remaining in the first half, and Vontae Davis gets beat again. Number 22 is a liability for this defense, and they've got to find a way to keep attacking him as that takes this ball game to halftime. 17-14, it's been fun. Offense playing well for Miami, everything we could hope for, but the defense, they've got some work to do against the ground game. Welcome back, everybody, to Hard Rock Stadium. Second half football here in week one, and deep to return is Devin Alexander to begin this third quarter. Alexander across the 30 and up to the 35-yard line, so great starting field position once again for an offense that's been playing pretty well. Obviously, this pass game has proved difficult to stop, and this run game hasn't looked too shabby either as they start with the run, and there's Kenyon Drake picking up another short gain, only 2.7 yards of carry so far. Second down and 8, Kenyon Drake this time picking up more yardage up to the 44 near first down. But what do they do on 3rd and 1? Shotgun look for the Dolphins. Here's another give. Kenyon Drake, 3 straight, runs it up to midfield. Tough running once again. And that extends the drive for the Dolphins. From the 46, Madavi, clean pocket once again over the middle. Zach Miller gets separation. Another nice, strong, and on-target throw from the rookie, Drew Madavi. 10-14 start, 184 plus the 2 scores. From the 32-yard line, here's Kenyon Drake again. Left side, fighting his way down to the 25. There's 7. Picking up the pace with the ground game. Here's 3rd down and 3. Madavi will throw. Here's pressure coming off the right side, and Madavi can't escape it in time. Casey beat for the second time, and here comes Jason Sanders, a 50-yard try from the left hash. Winnett is back. Tannehill, good hold. Kicks on the way, and that kick is right down the middle. Plenty of leg room, and the Dolphins lead by 6 points here in the third. So the offense once again finds a way to find points despite stalling. Can this defense stall out the Buffalo Bills on their half of the field as Teddy Bridgewater checks down to Zay Jones for a short gain? His front seven just needs to find a way to tack on some pressure. Bridgewater all day to throw on second down and again to Zay Jones. McCain can't get there in time. First down Bills again. Gotta be quicker and gotta be more aggressive on the perimeter. Here's a first and 10. McCoy gets it. He's shut down. Minka Fitzpatrick. Solid tackle there for no gain. That's the kind of run support we need to see from the secondary. Here's third down and 4. Bridgewater, quick throw left side this time, and Kelvin Benjamin's first grab of the season. Well, that's another Buffalo Bills first down. Something's got to give for this defense before the Bills get back in the scoring range. Here's second down, McCoy inside the 45, trying to find a first but can't get away from Fitzpatrick, and that sets up a very crucial third down. And the Bills going empty. Bridgewater obviously throwing the football here underneath. McCoy can't handle the football. Big hit there by Ryan Shazier. Fourth down, and they'll force a punt. That is crucial. What a stop for the defense. Now time for the offense to add more points. Here's Madavi throwing in pressure again. Taken down almost immediately. Madavi having a hard time staying upright with Casey getting beat consistently. Here's third, 19 to play later. Madavi, good time in the pocket. Floats one downfield, trying to find Gesicki, who didn't even go for the football there. So fourth and 19 and a quick three and out for Miami. Looked like a pretty good throw to me, but back to the Dolphins defense. And here's LeSean McCoy trying to get this drive moving downfield and runs into a brick wall. Six carries, 106, and the following eight runs for only 26 yards. That's a pretty big bounce back for this defense. Here's a throw on third down for Clay. This ball is stripped free by Jones. Beautiful coverage and another stop for this defense. They are really settling in here in the second half. But this offense can't get comfortable. You need more points. Here's a give, Kenyon Drake, and again, not getting much. Jerry Hughes, good wrap up there and keeping him to a three-yard run. A lot of snaps from the shotgun for Drew Madavi. Here's a second down throw, and again, here comes pressure. Trent Murphy again, just flying around DeMarcus Casey, who was without a doubt one of the, if not the most athletic offensive linemen in this draft, especially at the tackle position. And for whatever reason, he just can't contain Trent Murphy. Can Madavi avoid pressure on third down? Trent Murphy contained Madavi. Plenty of time and a strike to Kenny Stills, but Goddard, good coverage, and the rookie knocks it away. That's going to be a big-time drop if the Bills find a way to get back down the field and jump back in front. It's only a six-point ball game, and the Bills are definitely going to keep this football on the ground for the most part. It's been their bread and butter so far. Throwing on second down, Bridgewater steps right, throws over the middle to Kelvin Benjamin, who got away from Terrell Suggs and picks up another first down. From the Dolphins side of the field now, Bridgewater, plenty of time, running right and taken down. He's sacked by Robert Quinn. It's about time somebody got through, although Bridgewater broke containment there and they end up losing 10 yards. Second and 20, Bridgewater steps up again. Underneath Benjamin with the catch and another strong finish from Benjamin. Breaks two tackles and brought down by Christian Pedrino. Gotta buy a stop here on third down. Bridgewater running left, hit as he throws. Ball's on the ground, is kicked backwards and recovered by Goldman. And the Bills turn it over at the wrong time inside their own territory. This could be trouble. Pressure applied by Robert Quinn, forcing him to run left, but here is the big time play by the rookie LaMichael McKinney, getting most of his snaps so far in that nickel outside linebacker position. And now we're turning things back over to the Dolphins offense, who are trying to find a way to keep their quarterback upright and get this ball back down the field. Already pretty much in field goal range as Madavi throwing off balance down the field, and this is incomplete, a very Johnny Manziel type play that Kenny Stills for some reason couldn't catch. High formation, second down give, no, a play fake. Madavi outside on target this time. Mike Gesicki with the catch and inside the 10. Second effort gets him around 10 more yards there, and that's got Miami back in the red zone. Three catches now, 61 yards for Mike Gesicki. First and goal from the 6. Madavi backpedaling, throwing a flip pass left, trying to set up a screen, and that was not anywhere near set up in time. Second and goal from the 6. Here's Kenyon Drake up the middle trying to power his way in. Able to get this down to the 3-yard line, setting up third and goal. And This is where this offense couldn't get it done last time. Third down, Madavi looking, pressuring, coming. Could have maybe thrown to Parker if he had a little more time, but that pass incomplete. And unfortunately, it leads to another field goal, but it does make it a two-score game. 9-point lead here, 6:30 to go in the fourth quarter. Just got to find a few more stops on defense, but not if you're going to let the receiver get behind you, Ryan Shazier, beat by Coleman. And the zone cover so far has not been very sharp. It's not been great. Here's first and 10, Bridgewater underneath. LaShawn McCoy hit hard by Shazier, but he held on this time. Too much time to panic, too much time to rush. Here's second down from the 44. Bridgewater over the middle, finding Clay, who got separation from Jones and picks up another Bills first down. They are getting absolutely no pressure on Shazier. First and 10, pressure off the right side this time, and just in time is Terrell Suggs, and a loss of 11 yards. Even worse, a false start backs him up 5. Second and 26 from the 42. Bridgewater steps up, throws right, hits Coleman, but Coleman hit by Shazier even harder. That'll go incomplete, and Ryan Shazier's third pass breakup of this ball game. From the 42, third down, Bridgewater dancing around, floats one downfield in the double coverage. And McCain and Jones fighting for the interception. Someone should have had that. Fourth down, and the Bills are staying on the field. Bridgewater from the gun, three receivers left side. Two safeties playing deep. Bridgewater looking left and on target for Benjamin, and he caught the football. Unbelievable 34-yard gain on 4th and 26, and Minka Fitzpatrick, you've got to be more aggressive than this. Just stood there to let Benjamin catch the football, and the Bills keep this drive going. 3:30 to go in this fourth quarter from the 24. Pressure incoming, and McCoy got separation. And the Bills now down to the 11-yard line, but they need to score twice, so they've got to move quickly. Dolphins only rushing 4. Bridgewater all day to throw, and throwing right side to Corey Coleman. And that ball's jarred free. Clock stopped at 2:50. I formation to give to McCoy, and he's brought down quickly. Shane Ray there to finish off the run. 3rd and 8 now for the Bills. 2:17 to go. Bridgewater looking, pressuring, coming off the left side. He throws to the end zone. It's picked off. Minka Fitzpatrick back the other way. His first career interception, and the spin move's going to break him loose. Are you kidding me? What a time for your first pick, and the defense able to tack on points here to hopefully close out this ball game. Absolutely incredible, and coming at the perfect time, literally. As this game is just hitting the 2-minute mark, you'll see Shane Ray coming off the left side. Bridgewater threw a ball into triple coverage, and we might need to move Fitzpatrick to running back if he's going to have that kind of spin move. Bridgewater missed and Benjamin missed, and that's a path all the way back to the end zone for 6 points. Just under 2 minutes away from their first win at home this season. Bridgewater first down, throwing outside, and this ball's intercepted right into the hands of Bobby McCain. Who was Bridgewater throwing the football to? Zay Jones, the only receiver really working that way, and that ball just got away from Bridgewater, and I'm not sure why. It's not raining, but with that interception, that could likely put this ball game away. Here's Kalen Ballage up to the 30. Timeout called by Buffalo. Just need to find a way to keep this clock moving. I expect to keep this on the ground. As Madavi hands off, there's Kenya Drake with a strong run inside the 20. And Buffalo calls their second timeout. Not too sure why. You're down by 16. Miami's already in field goal range. And this ball game is a wrap. Final second ticks off the clock, and the Dolphins take week one as they finally beat the Buffalo Bills. Crazy to think where this game would have been if the Bills had kept Josh Allen as their starter, who beat us twice last year. But they bring in Teddy Bridgewater. We have a very good record against him. Now 3-0. And we're looking forward to one more matchup in a couple of weeks against the Bills. Overall, it wasn't too shabby of a game from the rookie quarterback, Drew Madavi. Pass completion percentage kind of fell off in the second half due to a lot of drops and some missed time throws. But overall, it wasn't a bad performance at all. Kenyon Drake had a great second half. Would have liked to see a little more from him in the first, but that'll just have to be something we keep in mind for next week. And due to all the incompletions, we didn't have a great number of receptions by guys like Kenny Stills and really anybody. Mike Kosicki only 4 grabs, but the yardage was definitely there. DeMarcus Casey giving up 4 sacks in 1 game, obviously not the best first impression. A lot of that has to do with just all Madden being all Madden, and I think this might be the final game we play on all Madden for the series. We might be moving to all pro for the rest of the season. Kane has a new slider set out. I might be using that. I haven't had a chance to test it. I haven't played Madden in like a month and a half, so obviously that's been a problem. Obviously, Teddy Bridgewater had himself quite a decent ball game. This is the one area where I'm kind of concerned about fall off for all pro. I really don't know if the offenses for these CPU teams are going to be able to play at a high enough level. They weren't earlier in the year when I was playing on all pro, testing things out, but we'll see what happens. Obviously, we could have been better on third down. 3 of 10 is not great. We kept the Bills to 4 of 11, so our second half defense definitely stepped up. But obviously, we've got a lot of things that we need to focus on. One of those things being upgrading our pass coverage. So Minka Fitzpatrick, the only player earning a skill point this game. Minka did earn superstar development during the offseason, and we will spend this upgrade on his hybrid scheme. So up acceleration, up in agility, up in awareness, play rec pursuit, and plus one zone coverage, which should hopefully help him from giving up fourth down conversions. So into week two we go. We're on the road in New York to take on the New York Jets, and we are one of three teams in our division at one, including the New York Jets, who won 22-17, and they've got the number two overall pick, Trey Ponder out of Pittsburgh. We're going to have to see him this game. One touchdown, only a 186 through the air, and sacked three times. Lucas Madison picked by the New England Patriots, on the other hand, 400 yards and four touchdowns, but also two interceptions. So he looks to be the gunslinger of this draft class. But that, guys, will do it for this episode of the Dolphins franchise. Thank you for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, leaving a like is always great. Also, subscribe if you're new and you want to see more. And I will catch you guys next time for hopefully another Dolphins win. See you guys then. Thanks for watching.